Get ready to match the stars from Ork and Mindy, Jim Stahl, Brett Summers, Charles Rochelle, from the Baxters, Anita Gillette, from Vegas, Bart Braverman, and from Angie, Deborah Lee Scott, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Raver.
Hello, John. Hey, friends. Welcome. You're going to have a good time. Because the loony bin has been opened up again, and they've all gathered here. Is this your first time, isn't it? We have to welcome her.
First time?
It is not.
Oh, are it's you
not
kidding? It's his first time.
Put the spray away. She's been here before.
Oh, you've been here before.
It's Jim's first time.
Oh, it's Jim's first time.
Your reputation is shaky enough without kissing
We have to give you an official welcome.
Just go with it. It's
what
a
is
job.
It, the spit?
No, usually when we have a lady who's on for the first time, I give her a little welcome kiss, you see, and we greet them. Anita hadn't been here in so long, I thought it was her first time. Yeah. Well, we're welcome
you
to you.
You can smell that stuff way over here. It's like a Vicks vapor rub.
Well, but you're from Mork or Mindy, but you're not Mork and you ain't Mindy.
No, I'm Mindy's cousin.
Mindy's cousin.
Nelson Flavor.
Pretty good-looking guy, isn't he?
Yeah.
Handsome? I think I'll kiss him anyway. Welcome. All right, now let's say hello to Davey Frankel and Bill Winslow over here. Good luck to both of you. Let's find out a little bit about each of you. Bill, we'll get acquainted with you first.
Okay, I'm from Pacific Palisades, California. I'm a lawyer, and I'm happily married.
Really?
Yeah.
We could change all that, couldn't we?
I think so.
Good luck to Bill. How about you, Davey?
I'm an elementary school teacher at Commonwealth Avenue Elementary School, and I'm going for my master's in juvenile justice.
Good working with kids, is it? You like that?
I love it.
Yes. How'd you get the name Davey? Sounds like a man's name.
Yes, I was born after my grandfather died, and his name was David. So they named me after him.
Oh, it's cute. Cute, Mom.
Got a draft notice?
You got a draft notice?
Yes, I did.
Okay, you can fight my army anytime. Look, you can have A or B.
A, please.
A for Bill Winslow. Everyone will play. Jack said, boy, is my dog intelligent. Mm. I told him to play dead. And he went out and got a blank. Are you ready?
Yes.
Well, we're now. Yes, we are. Jack said, boy, is my dog intelligent. I told him to play dead, and he went out and got a blank.
A casket.
A casket. All right. All right, Jim, this is your first time at bat. What do you say to that?
Wrong.
Wrong.
I said gun. And,
you went out and told him to play dead. He went out and got a gun. Well, that's okay.
See where I'm going with that?
Yeah. Because he was going to. The dog was going to shoot someone, right?
Yeah, he was going to shoot himself.
I see.
Swedish dog. He was suicidal. First time up, and I'm wrong.
No, it's all right, Jim.
That's okay.
There are no right or wrong answers here.
Yes, there are.
There are only good and bad ones. Only good and bad ones.
You'll find your colleagues are not too kind to you here either. But trust me, I'll be good to you. Jeez, what a rotten answer. All right.
Mean. You're a mean man. No, I threw a coffin in the slot, actually.
You threw it away?
Mm-hmm.
What do you got?
I went for shotgun.
Shotgun. She stole your answer, Joe.
I did not
bad
steal
taste,
his answer.
Runner-up award.
Now, a dog can't go out and get a gun or a shotgun or a casket. It's an impossibility.
Right.
But they could get an autopsy.
That's the worst answer you've ever given.
That's playing dead.
Yeah, you're very smart.
Clever, Charles. Very clever.
Not clever.
Clever. I don't understand it, but I guess it's clever. Now, Anita.
Yes, Gene.
You haven't played this game in a long time. Are you rusty?
Oh, yes. Obviously, I am, because I didn't say casket. I was thinking of like a corpse or a body or a stiff. I was trying to figure out. I said body, although you can't.
Body.
It's I said whatever,
whatever
stiff
it is.
First.
Oh, stiff. Yeah, that.
Stiff.
That's a colloquialism
for a
dead person.
Right, and then I thought
it
might not get. So
yes, of course. Let's just forget
mind.
About it there.
Okay.
Can we get someone else for this scene?
Hi.
Hello, Bart.
My answer is so incredibly stupid, I'm going to stall for a moment only by saying the first time I was on this show, my grandmother was here, and you took a shot of her, and it was very nice, and today is my grandmother's 90th birthday.
Happy birthday, Grandma. I want to say happy birthday to Grandma.
Where is she?
She's down back in the home. No, Grandma Beck's at my aunt's house. They're having a party, which I will go to when we are through filming and taping today.
Well, good. Give her our regards.
Gun.
You're
right. And he gave me grief.
Yes, he did. That's two for you, Jim. Okay, Deborah Lee.
Well, this is only round one. I said corpse.
Corpse. Casket is what we were after there for Bill Winslow, and we didn't get it. Now we come to Davy Frankel's question, our round wonder. Muggsy said, my neighborhood is so tough, they even have a bouncer at the local blank. All right, Davy. Muggsy said, my neighborhood is so tough.
Wait a minute, Mr. Slowpoke hasn't quite... There we go.
Muggsy said, my neighborhood is so tough, they even have a bouncer at the local...
Church.
Church is a good response, Davy. See, now, church is an unlikely place where you'd find a bouncer, right, Jim?
See, do I have to go first again?
You don't want to go first.
You always have to go first.
See, I was thinking really hard this time, see?
Yeah.
And I thought the last place there'd be a bouncer would be at the gas station's men's room. See, like, when you go to the men's room,
yeah,
that there would be a...
A bouncer there, right. Now, you would expect this lady, Davy, to say a gas station men's room.
See, I didn't take that in consideration.
Oh, well, that's you. We must keep that in mind next time, Jim, because that's how we play this game here. Oh, he's really going down. He's really dying.
Nice chin, though.
Nice chin. Nice hair. Does he dye his hair?
I don't know.
He's got a wonderful hair like that.
Good
hair. All right, Brett.
Nobody told Jim he was supposed to match the contestant. Oh, he just thought he had to come up with a...
See, that's Iris
Cutch's
fault.
...with a willy-nilly answer.
Yes.
Church.
Church it is. One.
See, I knew he stole my answer. He had an answer. He threw it away. He tossed away. He said,
no, I didn't
let me look at it.
No, I didn't throw it. No, I'm sorry. You're wrong. I didn't know.
I've ever seen
I can't spell Episcopal.
See, she's
crazy. Have you ever seen... Look at the way he spelled. I wouldn't mind.
Look at this one.
Look at the way he spelled.
You got a crazy older lady.
What? Episcopal Church.
Episcopal.
I didn't copy from her, and I didn't write anything before that.
Yes, you did.
I did not. She's all hot and bothered because a blonde is sitting to her right and she'll probably be out the next two shows. And between your mouthwash and her hot flashes, I want to go home.
Now, Anita, now you understand why you stayed away so long.
Exactly.
You see the madness that goes on here?
I know, because it takes a little time to get, you know, let yourself go as crazy as they are. I'm getting there. I'll be that way by the end of the day.
Of course you will.
Let's see. I thought of an unlikely place, but it wasn't as unlikely as I would have liked it to be as unlikely.
Church is what we're at.
Well, I went for school.
School is another unlikely place?
Unlikely, but...
All right. And there's the church from Bart. And that's two for Davy. And Deborah Lee has another church.
Easy.
And round one here. Score 4-0. Davy's favor. Round two coming up in a moment or so. Stay tuned. All right, here we go. Now, Davy, you're ahead. We'll ask you to go first. A or B?
B, please.
B it is. Two people play. Jim and Anita.
Oh, the dummies.
The two of you, right.
Retards.
Stanley the snob.
Pardon me?
Stanley the snob is a snob through and through. When he was lost in the desert, instead of crying, water, water, he cried, blank, blank.
No?
That's it. Okay. All right. Davy Frankel, Stanley the snob, is a snob through and through. When he was lost in the desert, instead of crying, water, water, he cried, blank.
Taxi, taxi.
What?
Now, what does water have to do with taxi?
Well, I don't know. He's a snob. He's not going
to
walk, right?
Oh, he's a snob. He wouldn't want to walk.
Right.
Well, I guess she didn't quite understand it, Jim. Did you understand it?
Yes. That's why I went with Perrier, Perrier.
There's the answer.
Because
that's her handwriting. Well,
there's an explanation for that.
Yeah.
She wrote it, and I accepted it.
Yeah, you didn't know how to spell
it. He didn't know how to spell it. He said, how do you spell, and I said...
Perrier, do you understand now?
Yes,
instead of water, water, he said Perrier, Perrier.
Somebody just had a goose.
Someone needs some Perrier out there.
Do you mean,
and Mr. Perrier fix
even
at noon.
The audience gets crazy here now?
That's true. Oh, yeah, especially the audience. Yeah. You should have been here yesterday. Wow.
Maybe I wish I were. I said the same thing that Jim did.
Perrier? All right. Well, that was the answer.
Good.
Now, Bill, you have one shot at it here, 4 to tie and 5 to win. Everyone will play.
Oh,
okay.
The dentist said to his nurse, "That last patient had the worst case of overbite I ever saw. She had teeth marks on her blank."
Wait a minute, I'm checking this question right now. I'm sorry, I'm not answering.
Yes.
I don't like things against overbites.
Just because you have a small overbite, you're very sexy looking. Aren't overbite sexy looking? How's your finger?
Let me see the question.
Don't you think it makes her look attractive to have an overbite?
Don't make fun.
The
last time people think overbite is sexy, you ever lay. Not on you, but on something. I hate this question.
You don't like it? Here we go.
Hello.
The dentist said to his nurse, "That last patient had the worst case of overbite I ever saw. She had teeth marks on her blank."
Boobs.
Boobs?
That's physically impossible.
Now, Jim, have you ever heard of that kind of an overbite?
Yes, I have.
You have?
But I didn't think it was that bad. So
really?
That's why I went with chin.
Chin is a logical, reasonable response.
And that's what we don't want, right?
No, what she had was some little teeth marks right here on her little collarbone.
Collarbone? Now, you must match the other 4 to stay in the game and achieve a tie. What have you got for us, Charles?
Oh, you're a bust.
A bust? There's one for him. Worst case of overbite I ever saw. She had teeth marks on her.
Yeah, well, I didn't know what gender this patient was.
Her.
See, I don't listen good. Yeah. I had chin because
chin.
I...
So that means Davey wins the game, and we have chin and knees.
You'll be back.
Okay, Davey, can you see right there, a little dot, if you please. Now, Bill, that's game one. You'll be back to play game number 2 a little bit later. We'll look forward to seeing you then. Bill Winslow will go, and you are here now. For the Big Money Superman. Ready for it? All right, there's the star wheel coming in, especially for you. Let's begin. We polled a studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Old enough to blank.
Oh, boy.
If you give us the answer they wrote down most often, you get $500. $250 for you if you match the second most popular answer, and then $100 for matching the third. Now, look over the 6 stars. Choose them one at a time, 3 of them. The ones who are establishing eyeball contact with you are the ones who are likely to have the answer. The others who are avoiding your gaze don't know nothing.
Charles?
Old enough to vote.
There's one.
Oh, you know, you're so excited. Did she call on you just now? Watch, I bet it begins with D and ends in K. That's why she's all giddy. Listen.
Jim?
Old enough to marry.
Old enough to marry.
Oh, boy.
Hey, you know,
you've heard of tall, dark, and handsome? He's tall, blonde, and dumb.
I didn't really... I wish I would know this was a popularity contest.
Anita?
I think that more people will be concerned whether they're old enough to drink.
Old enough to drink.
This is crazy.
We have old enough to marry, old enough to vote, old enough to drink. At this time, you have the option of choosing one of those or thinking up one of your own. What is your pleasure?
Old enough to drink.
Old enough to drink. All right, that's Anita's answer. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where?
None of
we'll
those
begin.
Are be up there.
What's that?
None of those are going to be up there.
What is going to be up there?
Old enough to
your
know
father.
Better.
Old enough to know better.
All right,
old
exactly.
Enough. Old enough to be a
old
father.
Enough
said
to know better is
going to
be the 500.
All right.
I meant it,
you bet in Vegas, don't you?
Yes, we do, actually.
Want to bet?
We bet the big bucks.
I'll bet you my...
I wouldn't bet
my
if
spritzer.
I
I'll see
you.
All right.
I'll
here we go. Let's see the $100 response. Old enough to drink.
Watch it, kid.
So you think it's going to be up there?
Yeah.
Kids are going to be up there.
You'll know better.
All right, let's take a look at the next one.
And old enough to be your better father.
On the top.
You're going to owe me money. Okay, Braverman, get your money ready.
Slide it.
Slide it.
No better. Oh, my God.
Sarah, 7 years ago.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Okay.
Gotcha.
Hey.
All right, that's why he's in Vegas and I'm here. Now, we'll carry on with you in a moment or so, but right now we want to do a little message for America, okay? Are you ready? Okay, now you $100 means at least you can play for us 10 times that amount, or $1,000. However, we do want you to spin the star wheel. If you get lucky and it ends up on one of the stars, you will double your money. You'll be playing for $2,000. Step right up there, my dear, and good luck to you. We'll all root for a double. Give it a go. Must make one revolution. Here it is. Up. Everything. The last thing I said was it must make one complete revolution, and it didn't. So give it a little more muscle. I'm sorry about that.
Give it a spin.
Sorry, those are the rules. There you go. Gotta go around once. $1,000, what you're playing for with Anita. You ready, my dear? You will, Anita will write hers, and yours will be verbal, Davey. We'll give it to you right now. Here it is. Blank cleanser. C-L-E-A-N-S-E-R. Blank cleanser. You put it in the slot when you're finished, as you normally do. Now she's finished. You give us the answer that she has. We give you $1,000. What do you say to that?
Cleaning. Cleanser.
Cleaner cleanser?
Cleaning cleanser.
Cleaning cleanser?
Cleaning cleanser. Seems a little redundant to me, but maybe Miss Dingbat said the same thing.
Actually, no, I didn't.
Oh, you didn't.
I said Ajax.
Ajax cleanser. Kitchen cleanser?
Bathroom good cleanser. One? Cleanser.
What's that?
Comet cleanser.
Comet, yeah, all of them. There are all kinds of them there. All right, Davey, you've got $100. Let's bring your opponent back. And here comes Bill Winslow. We'll play game number two. Welcome back, Bill. You know what Davey just said? Well, I said, I'm sorry you lost the money. She said, well, it's easier when you're at home playing this game. Why is it different here? Why do you think it's different here?
Lights.
The lights? We're a friendly bunch, though, aren't we?
Oh, yes.
Does it seem different to you?
A little harder to concentrate.
It is. Yeah, I guess so. All right, game number two. Bill, you can go first again.
B, please.
B it is. Everyone will play. You find it difficult to concentrate?
Everyone will play.
Are you nervous in the presence of a star?
I do. Next to him, I find it very difficult to concentrate. He keeps grabbing.
Oh, really?
I get it.
Here we go. Dean said, this town must really be tough. I just saw a car with a bumper sticker that says, honk if you love blank. Dean said that.
Dean said that?
Dean said that.
The town must be
tough. This town must really be tough. I just saw a car with a bumper sticker that says, honk if you love blank. All right, Bill. Dean said this town must really be tough. I just saw a car with a bumper sticker that says, honk if you love blank.
The Incredible Hulk?
The Incredible Hulk. Honk if you love the Incredible Hulk. Honk if you love the Incredible Hulk.
Is honk he
not,
for the Hulk.
Is the Incredible
honk
Hulk not
Hulk.
A lovable
honk.
Character?
Hey, honk for the Hulk. It could be a phrase.
Honk for the Hulk.
Honk for the Hulk.
You just made that up. Clever. Yes. Oh, these poets are... Yes, Jim?
I was going more generic on this one. honk if you love violence, you
that's
see.
That's a good response. That's okay. It's not a match, but it's all right. We must buoy him up. I don't want him to feel discouraged.
Not at all. He'll be fine. He'll be fine.
We positive must say kind things to him. Right? Right? Camaraderie, I work right. Better.
The pressure is destroying this boy. I said honk if you love M&S.
No, it's S&W.
Oh.
She wait, meant S&W is what best? She meant. You know that root beer that everybody loves?
S&W.
Okay, here we go, Chuck.
You can't even get that right. even I know that.
Come on now, Charles, let's see it.
Santa Monica.
Right.
Now, since it was road bumper stickers, I kept it a road orientated.
I like it.
Bad taste answer. Honk if you like hit and run drivers.
I need to tell us yours.
Speed up.
What? Show you my one? Oh,
there we
sure.
go.
Oh. I just narrowed it all down to pain.
Pain. Another generic
sort
answer like Jim.
S&M
what'd you get there, Bart?
Bart.
Following the footsteps of Inspector Clouseau, did you say a murderer?
Murder.
I didn't say a murderer.
Sadism.
Sadism. So, all right. You hang around for your question right now. This for you, if you please. Gene Aberdeen, join us next time. Match game. Thank you for joining us. Goodbye.
Some of our contestants will receive A 28 diamond Benrus fashion watch, adjustable Italian mesh bracelet, silver tone dial and case, precision 17 jewel movement by Benrus. And an Arrow wood stove. This unit is made of heavy steel construction, efficient, airtight, and a large built-in blower. Features include glass door and convenient ash drawer and an energy-efficient home accessory from Arrow. And Arelco's new 1200-watt professional-style hair dryer, lightweight, two-temperature airflow speed settings, for styling and drying from Norelco. And leading furniture manufacturers recommend Guardsman furniture polish. Guardsman, the finishing touch for fine furniture. And Nova Histine cough products all have the cough-controlling ingredient the doctors recommend most. Nova Histine, you can't buy better care for a cough. Use as directed. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.